Mr. Finn is an English and studio art major from Richmond, Virginia. He is also the president of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity and vice president of the Black Expressions Awareness and Thought Society. Next, we have Mr. Clarence Hawks III. Mr. Hawks is a Foreign Affairs and African American Studies major from Blackstone, Virginia. He's a senior peer advisor and program tri-chair at the Office of African American Affairs. He is also a mentor or tutor for the University of Virginia Madison House. Next, we have Mr. Baz Maguzi. He is a biomechanical engineering major from Kampala, Uganda. He is a member of the Biomedical Engineering Society and Organization of African American Students, African Students, and gaining his research experience in cardiac biomechanics. Next, we have Mr. Byron Nicholas. He is a pre-commerce major from Newport News, Virginia. He's a peer advisor at the Office of African American Affairs, and he is also a member of the Black Commerce Student Network. Next, we have Mr. Nabe Oboto. D.C. He is a member of the Organization of African Students and also the Virginia Thema Society, and is working on preparations for law school. Next, we have Mr. Lolan Sego Moses. He's a political and social thought major from Accra, Ghana. He is president of the Organization of African Students and a member of the Jefferson Literary and Debating Society. Next, we have Mr. James Scott III. He is the current president of the National Society of Black Engineers. Next, we have Mr. Anthony T. Anthony is a physics major from Harrisonburg, Virginia. He is secretary and telecommunications chair for the Brothers United Celebrating Knowledge and Success. He's also a member of the Outreach Student and Admissions Committee and an upcoming entrepreneur. Next, we have Mr. Joseph Williams. Mr. Williams is a political and social thought major from Sterling, Virginia, co-president of the Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity, and marketing chair for the Black Expressions Awareness and Thought Society, and also helping one of our other supporters, Mr. London, on the UVA football field. And last but definitely not least, we have Mr. Matthias. He's the chair of the Black Leadership Institute and also a counselor at the University Judiciary Committee. Again, we present to you our charter of membership for the Collegiate 100 at the University of Virginia.
definitely an impressive group. We look forward to working with him. For closing remarks, we are fortunate to have a member of the Executive Committee of the 100 Black Men in America with us today, Brother Marvin Dickinson, member at large. He truly represents the phrase, friendship is essential to the soul. And I say that because of his tireless work with this organization. He's a relationship builder. He understands skills and leadership. He's going to leave here today and go to Tennessee. He's all over the place. So we are very fortunate. He's a mentor for all of us. So please join me in welcoming a UVA graduate, President and Chief Executive Officer of Dickinson Technologies, and he was recently named Citizen of the Year for a chapter, maybe Southside chapter, in Springfield, Maryland, somewhere, because of the work that he's doing with the achievement of African American males. So we are so proud to have you here representing real men in real time.
First of all, thank you, President Hurston, and on behalf of our chairman, I must say to first and foremost, these brothers that are standing on the stage, well done, well done, well done. First class event. Give them a round of applause. I will be very brief because many of the things that I will share to you with you tonight have already been spoken. But there are a couple things that I want to leave with you young men. But before I do that, I think it's important to recognize the fact that in 1984, I first stepped foot in Charlottesville. And I must tell you, I never thought that I would see this type of day happen on campus of the University of Virginia. And I am, as an alum, I am tickled pink. And that would be tough. But I am glad to see this type of occasion happen on these grounds. Before we started the program, a couple of my colleagues, this is their first time coming to the University of Virginia, and I gave them a brief mentoring moment. I said, there are certain things that we say when we're here. We don't say campus, we say grounds. We don't say freshman, sophomore, and seniors, we say first year, second year, third year, fourth year. And we recognize that some of us spend more than 4 years here. But I can tell you, every time I come back to Charlottesville, I see the potential, I see the growth. And as an alum, I am very proud of what I see from my university. I travel all over the world. I've been on many campuses. I've been on many grounds, or what we used to say back in the day, the yard. And I must tell you, I brag about the University of Virginia any opportunity. Before we got down here this evening, I told some of the young men from Morgan State, I said, I want you to remember something. When you pull on this university and you pull up to Dartmouth, I want you to recognize when I was here, Dartmouth was one building. Dartmouth is bigger than some small universities today. And that's because of the legacy, the work, and the commitment of our graduates and our alums. So young men, there are certain things that I think that you need to take to heart. Last week, for the last 2 weeks, as President Hurston alluded to, I've been zigzagging all over this country on behalf of the 100, attending meetings with mayors and different folk. But one stuck out in my mind. I was on campus, Temple University, and we were talking about the homicide rate. And the Department of Justice and a room full of mayors from all many major cities across the country were putting up statistics, and it was saying 2009-2010 data, 80% of the homicides in every major city across this country are African American males, black on black crime. We have work to do. But I'm confident, because you're at the University of Virginia, you are leaders, that you take on these challenges, both in your community and as you graduate and matriculate out into the workforce, into your new communities. I have no doubt we will be successful, but I'm not concerned about your success. I'm interested in you being significant. I want you to make a difference in the communities that you go into. These men that are staying behind me don't have to do what they do. They're all successful in their own right. Your parents were successful in their own right. But they made commitments to you so that they can make a difference. There are three things that I will tell you that are important in making that transition from success to significance. Number one, your character must be beyond reproach. You will be looked at by your peers, your colleagues. You wear this pin, now your collegiate pin. They will expect different behavior and different things from you. You must deliver it. The second thing is integrity. Second to none. You give your word, you commit to something, you deliver it. There's nothing worse than a man that does not keep his commitments. So keep your commitments. And the third thing, which I think is more important, remember that God placed you on this earth to make a difference. It's really not about you. There is someone that says, change, make a difference in someone's life, and it will last a lifetime, well beyond your existence. So change lives, impact people, make a difference. And before I step away, I want to acknowledge several of my mentees that are here in this audience. Will the Williams boys, please, the young men from the Williams family, please stand. These are three gentlemen that I've been working with in Washington, D.C. in our Sarah Leadership Academy since they were in the 8th and 9th grade. And they are still matriculating and doing what they do. I'm glad Joseph has made the mistake of telling me that UVA was his first choice, and he's here. Michael, I understand we need to have a talk. It's going to happen. Joseph told me. So that's good. But Ms. Williams, it's very good to see you and your daughter. See, relationships don't stop just because you matriculate from high school or college. It's about mentoring across the lifetime. So these relationships you're forming now, when you're 40 years old, because some of my mentors are on this stage, Dr. Benny Page, the dentist in Charlottesville, my fraternity brother, that I remember when I was first year, that told me where Rose Hill Barbershop was, okay? I see Xavier and I went to school together. I see Dr. Whitsett and Lincoln Lewis. You know, Dr. Whitsett and the Pages are related to Luther B. Jackson, the Luther B. Jackson House. So, family is important. But these are some of the men that were in the community. Where's, I still call him Dean Rick Turner. Dean Rick Turner, when I was in grad school here, I was a graduate advisor at the Office of African American Affairs. Being returned, I was also on the search committee because I was in student leadership that helped pick Dean Turner when he came here to be an office African American. Relationships matter. Okay? It matters. So I said I'll be brief, I'm done. But on behalf of all of these men here, I congratulate you. I wish you well. Thank you.
We will need the young men to stay back. We need to record the history of this night. So we will need a group photo. We will also need these men to stay back for a group photo. So this meeting is officially adjourned.
Thank you. So you don't say things to me about...
It's just not like that.
I just did this like really nice.
know, because you used to go hug my photo.
Okay.
You hug my photo with a trench coat?
Thank you. Thank you.
I was going to say, hey, but you just called me at a bad moment.